Hi everybody. Today I will try to explain you about capacitive voltage divider. But before I continue, I would like to talk about something else. Please apologize my English. Some viewers are complaining about my English and also about poor quality of my video. Maybe I should have told you this earlier. First, English is not my main language. Second, I'm not a talking person in general. Okay? I'm an Indonesian who currently living in Germany. So, I speak German and Indonesian. I don't speak English regularly. So please apologize for that. Okay? Now let me continue. Here you can see my schematic. This is a capacitor or two capacitors or a capacitor with extra plate, and here as an input I have 230 volt AC, and here as a load I have 20 watt 230 volt light bulb. Okay. Here we have full voltage, AC voltage, and here we can vary the distance between both electrodes, and we will see the behavior of this capacitor. Okay, here is my actual setup. Here is my electrolyzer, but I will use this as a capacitor. This is actually a capacitor, a water capacitor. Okay. This is the cable connection. I will connect this to the AC plug, the wall socket. Okay. Here is my oscilloscope. Here is my isolation transformer for the oscilloscope. Here is my full wave rectifier or bridge diode, and here I have two light bulbs. One I will connect it directly to the capacitor like this, and the other one I will connect it to this bridge diode. Okay. I will open this. This is stainless steel plates. I have here 30 plates, and I have here just tap water. Okay, now I'm going to connect this to the 230 volt AC. Okay, this is the connection. And I'm going to connect this light bulb to the plate of the cell. Okay. And now we'll connect this to one of the cells. Okay. Now I'm going to turn on the switch. Now we see the power input, 215 watts. Now, watch this. If I connect to the outermost plate, okay, now I'm going to move this plate and move this connection to the other plate. Can you see the difference? Okay. Now, I'm going to show you the voltage reading of this capacitor. Here I have the setting on AC voltage. Volts. This is the other probe. I'll turn on the switch. It's on. Now I will connect this to the outermost plate. You can see the voltage is 225 volts. If I connect to this plate or to this plate, to this plate, to this plate, okay, outermost plate, okay. Turn it off. Now I'm going to show you the waveform, the voltage waveform of this capacitor. Okay. Turn the switch on. And we will see, we connect it to the outermost plate. Maybe it's better if I do like this. You see? Now I'm going to sweep the put this probe on the water, not to the plate, and I will show you the voltage. You see? Just touching the water. Without touching the plate. Okay. Turn it off. Now I'm going to show you about the frequency doubling of this bridge diode. This is the AC terminal, and this is the positive output, and this is the negative output, and I will just connect this somewhere here. Okay, now I'm going to this is okay, it's okay. Now I'm going to turn on the switch. The light is on, and you see now the waveform is different than the there is no sinusoidal waveform anymore. Now the negative part of the voltage is inverted, and you will have double the frequency. Okay. I think that's it for now. Again, the voltage is depends on the distance of the or the position of the extra plate here. If the extra plate goes to this closer to this plate, to this plate of the capacitor, the voltage is increasing. If the this extra plate going down to this plate, the voltage is decreasing. Okay, I hope this is clear enough, and I think that's it for now. Until next video, bye bye.